The anti-terror counselor, ATC, designates as terrorists 19 people it alleges to be Central Committee members of the Communist Party of the Philippines. This authorizes the Anti-Money Laundering Council to freeze their assets under the anti-terror law, whose constitutionality is being challenged in the Supreme Court. In a resolution signed April 21 but uploaded only on Thursday, May 13, the council designates CPP founding chairman Joma Sison and top National Democratic Front or NDF peace consultants Vicente Ladlad, Adalberto Silva, Rafael Bailosis, Wilma Tiamson, and Benito Tiamson. Bailosis is free after he was cleared in 2019 of charges of illegal possession of firearms and explosives. Sison is exiled in the Netherlands. The Tiamson couple are at large since President Rodrigo Duterte ordered their rearrest following the collapse of the peace talks. They were convicted for kidnapping in November by a Quezon City court. Ladlad and Silva were arrested in 2018 for charges of illegal possession of firearms and explosives. In a statement Thursday, Sison says he and his wife are not bothered by the designation. He claims publicly known NDF peace consultants are all entitled to the protection of the GRP-NDFP, Joint Agreement of Safety and Immunity Guarantees. Designation is one of the most contentious powers of the feared anti-terror law. Associate Justice Benjamin Kagiwa earlier pointed out in oral arguments, the designation by an executive body made up of cabinet members already achieves the purpose of prescription. Prescription is the distinct court process to judicially declare a group as terrorist. In December 2020, the ATC designated the CPP as a terrorist group. The Commission on Elections or COMELEC awards multinational corporation Smartmatic a 402 million peso contract to provide software for the automated election system in the 2022 presidential polls. COMELEC publishes the contract with Smartmatic Monday, May 10, but the two parties signed the deal on May 4. This despite calls of groups and personalities including President Rodrigo Duterte to replace Smartmatic due to fraud allegations. The COMELEC used Smartmatic technology in all of the Philippines' four previous automated elections. Meantime, COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez urges the public not to vote for politicians who fail to comply with COVID-19 health protocols, saying that electing them means rewarding that behavior. In a Rappler Talk interview, Jimenez says Filipino voters should hold irresponsible politicians to account.
You see a politician casually disregarding COVID protocols? Send the joker to loser heaven, you know? Don't make them win.
The campaign period for the 2022 Philippine elections begins in February next year. The Department of the Interior and Local Government on Thursday, May 13, refutes that contact tracing is the weakest link in the Philippine government's pandemic response. On May 4, contact tracing czar Benjamin Magalong made that assessment. He noted that the contact tracing efficiency ratio for COVID-19 cases and their contacts in Metro Manila was 1:5 as of late April. Still far from the reduced target of 1:15.
Kami po sa DILG have never believed na ang ating contact tracing is the weakest link. No? Actually, we disagree. In fact, doon po sa ating EDIT, our strategy, which is prevent, detect, isolate, trace, and rehabilitate or reintegrate, sa tingin ko po ang pinaka-weakest link natin is yung ating prevent, prevention. Kaya nga po tayo nang huhuli ng mga kababayan natin hindi sumusunod sa mga minimum health standards.
Malaya points out, the DILG already beefed up its contact tracing efforts in May, with over 5,700 additional personnel deployed to Metro Manila. He says, a year into the pandemic, many still don't wear their face masks and face shields properly, resulting in the apprehension of over 18,000 individuals from May 6 to 10. A Davao del Norte resort is being criticized for refusing to accommodate transgender guests, claiming it lacks facilities for them. In a Facebook post Monday, May 10, trans woman Shannon Gonzaga says Islareta Beach Resort blocked her from using their women's bathroom during her stay at the resort. She says, one of the resort's employees asked for proof she had undergone sex reassignment surgery before allowing her to use the bathroom of her choice. On Wednesday, May 12, Islareta Beach Resort responds to the incident and says it has, quote, no facility for transgender guests to avoid issues of discrimination. Later that night, the resort issues a statement explaining that other female guests have previously said that they were uncomfortable sharing shower rooms with trans women. Members and allies of the LGBTQ community slammed the resort for its policy. Miss Trans Global 2020 Mela Habihan says the mere refusal to accommodate transgender guests is in itself an act of discrimination. In an interview on GMA's One Mindanao, resort owner Mario Reta clarifies that the policy is meant to protect women from possible sexual attacks. He argues transgender women who have not undergone sex reassignment surgery can still impregnate a cisgender woman. The controversy revives calls to pass the Sexual Orientation and Gender Identity and Expression, or SOGI, bill. A total of 34 organizations sign a joint statement urging Isleta Beach Resort to work with the LGBTQ+ community to make their policies more inclusive. Ellen DeGeneres reveals Wednesday, May 12, she is ending her long-running talk show in 2022. In an interview with The Hollywood Reporter, she talks about the need to be challenged as a creative person. As great as this show is and as fun as it is, it's just not a challenge anymore. I need something new to challenge me. DeGeneres adds the decision was several years in the making and she was supposedly stopping after season 16. She says she is already thinking of what to do next in her career, including a possible return to movies. Allegations of a toxic work environment hounded the show in 2020. But the TV star insists it is not the reason she is quitting. The Ellen DeGeneres Show began in 2003, receiving over 60 Daytime Emmy Awards, including the Outstanding Talk Show and Outstanding Talk Show Entertainment Awards.